This is one of the ElectroWeld brand micro butt welder, 5 kVA. On this you can butt weld MS wires from 1 to 5 mm dia, SS wires from 1 to 5 mm, copper wires from 1.5 to 3.5 mm, aluminum wires from 1.5 to 6 mm dia, also brass wires, as well as high carbon wires from 1 mm to 4 mm dia, as well as GI wires. This machine can be supplied without trolley, with trolley, without vise, with vise, without grinder, with grinder, as per the customer's requirement. Now we will show you the parts of this micro butt welder. These two here are the welding jaws. It has got three different grooves for welding thinner wire on the first two, medium wires for them. Now we will show the machine parts. These are two chromium zirconium copper welding jaws which has got three grooves for different diameter of wires. These are the gunmetal clamping levers. These are the annealing jaws. This over here is a current selector switch. Depending upon the diameter of the wire, you can increase the current or decrease the current. Now here at number 1 you have minimum current, then current keeps on increasing as the number goes up. We have up to 8. This is a maximum current. This over here is the gap adjusting lever. The gap to be adjusted between the two jaws, this one and this one, for different diameter wires. The different diameter wires can be set on this cam with the help of this lever and the pointer provided here. Supposing you want to weld 2 mm dia wires, then this knob you move such a way that 2 mm on the scale coincide with the pointer. This over here is the pressure adjustment nut. If you want to increase the pressure, you can tighten the nut. If you want to decrease the pressure, you can loosen the nut. But that need not be touched because this is pre-adjusted at our works. This over here is the main supply indicator. This one is a on-off switch for the grinder. This over here is a welding and annealing switch. This machine at the moment is mounted on the wheeled trolley. Now we will show you the butt welding of say 2 mm plus 2 mm thick wires. First of all, you cut the wires on the cutter exactly at right angles to the surface. Then clean the wires like this with the polished paper so that any dust or dirt or oil is removed from the wires like this before butt welding. Now to weld 2 mm plus 2 mm thick wires, first of all we have to adjust this lever over here at number 2 like this, and then adjust the current that also say number 3. Then you can clamp the wires by depressing this gunmetal lever and inserting the wire in the center groove like this, and then releasing this lever. Similarly, you can clamp this wire from this side like this and see that the wires are held between the two welding jaws in the center. Now you can take this lever beyond zero to its starting position so that now the wires are under pressure for welding. For welding the wires, depress this push button till the welding is over and current gets cut off automatically, just like this. Now see, the welding is over. Now you can release the button. Declamp the wires by depressing this lever. Again, increase the gap. Take it to original position. Then clamp the wires to be annealed in these two annealing jaws so that welded joint is in midway, and then tighten the wire like this. Now again, for annealing, you can depress the same button till you get the reddish tinge of the welded joint. Like this. Then you can release the button. Now the joint is welded properly and annealed. Now you can pass this welded joint through the dies, but before that, kindly do the grinding of the burr on this grinder like this. Now you can switch off the welder. If the joint is now welded properly and the burr also is ground properly, now you can pass this welded joint through dies for further process.
Start.
Now we'll show you once again the welding of 5mm plus 5mm SS wire rods. For this, we have to again adjust the current over here, say keep at number 6, and this gap between the two jaws to be increased to say number 4 over here. Kindly see that the cam scale number 4 coincides with the pointer. Now you can clamp the wires by depressing this lever and holding in the last groove like this, and the right side again, put the wire in the last groove, release the levers, then again take this cam lever beyond zero to its initial position. Now the wires are under pressure for welding. You can depress this button and you will see the welding will take place and the current will get cut off automatically.
Okay.
See, the welding will take place and current gets cut off automatically. Now again, declamp the welded joint like this. Take this cam lever to number 4 again and clamp the welded joint in the annealing jaws in midway and tighten. For annealing, again press the button over here. You will see that the joint gets reddish hot for annealing. Once the joint is reddish hot, it means the joint is annealed properly. Now you can declamp the welded joint, do the grinding on the grinder like this. Now you can switch off the grinder and pass the welded joint through the dies. Thank you. You can also weld round rings or bangles on this machine by clamping the rings like this under the clamping levers and then taking levers back and then depressing this button, see how it is welded. Now you can declamp the welded rings from the welding jaw and see the welding done. Similarly, you can do the grinding on the grinding machine provided and use the rings.
Okay.
After using some time this welding machine, carbon accumulates on top of the welding jaw grooves as well as under the welding jaws. Therefore, you remove the welding jaws, clean the carbon at the bottom as well as top of the welding jaws, clean the seats, then clamp the welding jaws for proper welding current available on the machine. This is very necessary. This over here, this side, is a troubleshooting chart. Here the problems are given, the causes of the problems are given, the remedies of the problems are given. In any case, supposing the machine does not work properly, kindly read this troubleshooting chart and try to solve the problem. If problem is not solved, you can contact us at our works or office. Thank you.